Hello everybody, I am Dr. Keshav Valase from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this session, we will discuss about production consumption inventory model, but particularly through numerical aspects. At the end of this session, students are expected to understand what is the concept of economic order quantity or economic batch quantity, as well as associated inventory costs for this particular model we have selected, that is production and consumption type of inventory model. At the same time, in a numerical perspective, students are expected to understand the concept of what it really means with production and consumption inventory model. Now, these things are discussed at length in earlier videos of derivation. Here, it is just again, we are revisiting the symbols and notations. This we are not really discussing here because stepwise details are given in earlier video. In concise form only, I will just mention here that this is the cost equation wherein this first term from here 1/2 QC1 and till up to this K, this corresponds to the holding cost term, and this second part C3 by T, it corresponds to the setup cost. Here C2 we are not considering because in the assumptions holding cost is assumed to be zero. Thus, this is the cost equation again in altered form, T replaced in terms of small q, that is batch size. Here in earlier holding cost calculations also we had capital Q, that was holding quantity, which is again replaced in terms of small q, and for setup cost T is again replaced in terms of small q because we are basically interested in knowing what is small q, that is what quantity we should manufacture. And deriving this cost equation partially with respect to the parameter q, small q, and equating that to zero for the cost to be minimum, and solving that equation, we ultimately get this relation of small q star, which we call as economic batch quantity, which is given with this particular relation in equation number 2. And next is minimum cost associated with this EBQ. Substituting this Q star back to this cost equation number 1 and simplifying, we get that cost, which is minimum cost, hence named as C minimum, this cost with formula number 3. So all these things we have revised again here. Now we aim at understanding the numerical part, that is understanding the model with some numbers, so that sometimes without numericals, understanding the concept with only symbols becomes a little difficult. So I intend to refer some numbers and explain or discuss what is the real meaning of a production and consumption type of inventory model. Now here, let's assume this K, capital K, which is production rate. Let us assume this production rate as 60 units per day, that is we are producing 60 units in one day. Secondly, consumption rate indicated by symbol R, let us assume it as 20 units per day, that is we are producing 60 units in a day and we are consuming 20 units in a day. Remember, in earlier video we have discussed this K must be greater than R. Rate of production has to be more than rate of consumption, then only we will be able to reach to some capital Q, the holding quantity, to point A. Hence, this K we are assuming 60 per day, whereas R, the consumption rate, we are assuming as 20 units per day we are consuming. Now with this, for the simplicity of discussion and understanding, we take this T1 in the graph. If you take this T1 is the time of production as well as consumption from origin to C point. This is a T1 is equal to 10. Now this 10 days, I repeat again, we are manufacturing the quantity. So this line indicates inventory built up at the rate of K minus R. Then T2 is 20 days. It is this particular time from C to B, the second part of the cycle. Point C to point B, it is a T2, which is a 20. During this cycle, during this period, that is from C to B, along line A to B, we are only consuming the quantity which was raised to point A, that is Q, capital Q. So this quantity will be now consuming down to zero till point B. So now with these assumptions, we'll again go ahead and try to understand what it is. Before that, I expect you all people to think about the different values of K and R, that is different values of production rate K and consumption rate R. Take some different cases, different values, assume these also different values, and that in case of any manufacturing industry that you think of, maybe in auto industry or any fan manufacturing, machine tool manufacturing industry. For such industry, in practical application side, you just think of a case and how does it reflect for that particular industry you are thinking. Now going ahead, these are the things we have assumed, we have discussed earlier. And now capital Q, that is this quantity, capital Q, we get with the rate at which we physically build the inventory. Remember, I repeat again, we are manufacturing 60 units per day and we are consuming 20 units per day. The difference of these two, this K minus R, is nothing but the inventory built up rate. Physically along this line at the rate of K minus R, here it is equal to 40, at the rate of 40 per day, we are building the inventory physically for holding in the store. And that we are doing it for T1 time period. So mathematically in symbolic notations, capital Q comes out to be K minus R in the bracket into T1, which if we substitute the values, it gives 40 into 10 is equal to 400 units. So this is the quantity we are holding. Physically, we are holding 400 units. If you see here, point A corresponds to quantity capital Q, which is 400 physically holding. But actually, how much we have manufactured? That is a small Q. Small Q we can get with capital K, that is production rate into time of production. Time of production is this T1, which is equal to 10. Thus, this small Q is equal to 60 into 10. That gives us 600 units, the quantity manufactured. I make the difference clear here again. This small Q is the quantity actually we have manufactured, and this 400 capital Q is the quantity physically we are holding. Going next, little further ahead, these two things we have discussed, capital Q as 400, small Q as 600. We have manufactured 600, but we are physically holding 400. Now let us look at what is happening to consumption during T1. Now consumption during T1, if you want to calculate, that is during this T1 period, in 10 days, how much we are consuming? Our consumption rate is 20 per day. And we are now considering T1 time period. So we multiply R and T1, that will give us the consumption during time T1, which is 20 into 10 is equal to 200. Similarly, consumption during T2 time period, that is during 20 days from C to B, it will be consumption rate R into corresponding time T2. So here both are 20 into 20, that gives us 400. So this 400 will be consuming it down to zero. Thus, in a nutshell, if we talk, Small Q is the quantity we actually manufactured, 600 units we actually manufactured. Out of that, 200 units we consumed while we were producing during T1. 600 minus 200, it will be 400. So this 400 is the actual physical holding quantity here. And at this point A, we are stopping the manufacturing. And then we only consume along the line A to B. So I repeat again, point O to A, we are producing as well as consuming. Whereas from point A to B, we are only consuming the quantity which was raised to 400. Thus the name comes up, production consumption inventory model. So ultimately in T1 time period, we consume 200 units. In T2 time period, whatever the 400 holding was there, that 400 we consume down to B, that is to zero. And then again the same cycle repeats. Thus, whatever the values we calculated, we can refer this EBQ, that is Q star and C minimum formula using C1, C2, C3, here C2 is 0, but otherwise in general, we can substitute the values here and calculate these two main parameters which are indicated in this total cost versus quantity graph. So this EOQ or EBQ corresponds to this formula, this value, that is, this is economic, is Q star, and this corresponds to minimum cost. Point to be taken care of is R and C1, both must be in same time units. These are the two books I recommend here. Thank you.